All right, you may have seen our next guest recently on Jimmy Kimmel or in Rolling Stone magazine.
Award-winning singer-songwriter Drew Holcomb has recently returned from a world tour playing for hundreds of thousands of people in support of his new album, Medicine. And guess what? We get to claim him. He is from Memphis. His family still lives here, and he's doing something pretty special for your hometown.
Drew, good to have you back home.
Yeah, good to be here. Thanks for having me.
The second annual Moon River Music Festival. And last year, correct me if I'm wrong, it was the largest gathering ever at the Levitt Shell.
Yeah, largest paid attendance in the
Levitt
Shell.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it was insane. We had a blast. We just never dream you put something on and it goes so well.
And the people actually come.
Yeah. And for those who didn't get a chance to make it last year, what is this like for them?
So, for me, I wanted to do two things. One, I wanted to bring my fans from all over the place to Memphis to get to experience what I think is a very underrated place. Mm-hmm. And so we had people from 24 different states buy tickets last year, which was really cool. And so the second thing I wanted to do is bring bands that we've met all around the country that we've done festivals with or toured with, and bring them and introduce them to our fans. Kind of like it's a festival, but in a way it's like a family reunion. Mm-hmm. It's a very intimate, fun, relaxed music festival. So family friendly. And we play both nights, and then we also kick off the day because I love it. I always hated when I played a festival night. It was a great festival, but I was early and no one was there yet.
I can imagine.
Yeah, so we play first as well as last to make sure everybody comes on time.
That's a good way to do it, Drew. It really is.
It.
Yeah. Talk to us also about your music.
Yeah, so, I grew up here in Memphis. My family is we're a road trip family. We had a big conversion van because I had a brother that was in a wheelchair, and so my dad made this decision that we're going to travel a lot. So music for me was just like always a soundtrack for a road trip, and it was everything from Motown and Bob Dylan to Al Green and all the stuff coming out of Memphis. And my parents just loved the oldies, and it just instilled in me a love of songs.
So if you had to name your genre for the for your band, what would it be?
I guess most people kind of call it Americana, which is, it's a little bit of soul, a little bit of rock, a little bit of country, a little bit of folk. It's a melting pot.
But your wife is also a Dove Award winner.
That's right, yeah.
So that's kind of, and yet she's also a member of your band.
Yeah.
So it's kind of
She's
cool.
kind of like a member emeritus.
That's a good way to put it. Yeah. A diplomatic way to put it also.
Sleeping in the doghouse tonight if she doesn't like that.
So, Drew, what's the message of your music?
I think for me, the message of my music is, more than anything, is to remind people they're not alone. Mm. I think for me, if I look back on music's impact on my life, it's been at some of the lowest and the best times. Music has been soundtracking that. So lowest time for me was in high school. I lost a brother, and music was the thing that kept my head above water and all that. And then think about the happiest of times for me, having children or getting married, and always soundtracked by music. And so I think for me, if my music can just play that role in people's lives in some small way, then I consider it successful.
That is so, so cool. And you have been successful. Sold out to Ryman recently on Jimmy Kimmel. What was that like?
It was great. It was Vince Vaughn and Mike Tyson were the other guests, and Jimmy and his crew were, I expected it to be really uptight, and it was actually super relaxed. We were there all day. And
he didn't make you play any stupid games or anything?
No, we didn't, we didn't get to get that much attention from him. I wish we could have,
That'll be the next time.
Next time, right.
All right, so Drew, what are you going to do for us this morning?
Yeah, so I'm going to play a song off my latest record called Here We Go, and it goes like this.
Okay.
Need the microphone though.
You might.
Sometimes I feel like a criminal, feel like a castaway. This world keeps changing and I can't keep the pace. It's like a race I didn't know I was running. But there are some things like rudders in a storm, someone to keep you warm, a friend to raise a glass, to take off your mask, to tell the truth and just be you. Make sense of it all tonight. Whoa, no, here we go. It won't be the last time. Oh, yeah, all right. Trying to make sense of it all tonight. Whoa, no, here we go. It won't be the last time. Shouting and struggling and feeling like you're nothing. Trying not to give in, not to take it on the chin. Trying to wear your
thickest set of skin. Oh, music, it makes you feel so good, makes you feel understood, like you're not alone, not a rolling stone. You're not the only one on the road. Oh, yeah, all right, trying to make sense of it all tonight. Whoa, no, here we go, it won't be the last time. It all seemed pretty plausible, but it became impossible. The promises you made and you got betrayed, and all the things that you still don't know at the end of the day. Oh yeah, all right, trying to make sense of it all tonight. Whoa, no, here we go, it won't be the last time.